There's been a lot of disquiet in seats like Blaxland and Watson. We talk about Tony Burkey holds one of those seats, Jason Clare holds the other one. And they're arguing there's a lack of action by Labor when it comes to Gaza. Caroline, you must almost fall off your chair when you read that. I mean, goodness gracious me. I mean, a lack of government concern about Gaza? Give me a break.
Well, I think if for some of these people, I think anything short of just calling the conflict a genocide, which is clearly absurd, or just buying into that sort of extreme language, pro-Hamas language, is falling short in their books. But it's really concerning that this is happening because the government has, and the Prime Minister in particular, has been so weak on calling out anti-Semitism. And this pressure from candidates in seats that they might consider at risk will put even more pressure on the government to kind of speak out of both sides of their mouth, as they have been doing on this issue, and kind of courting that vote. I mean, the ministers that you mention in particular, Jason Clare and Tony Burke, have been particularly woeful when it comes to the language that they've used around this conflict and the response at home. Mr. Clare, the education minister, was so slow to call out those pro-Palestinian encampments that are happening on university campuses, and at one point even tried to pretend that from the river to the sea didn't mean exactly what we all know it to mean, which is genocide. That's genocide. Meanwhile, Tony Burke has been tap dancing around the term genocide and dog whistling to some of these more extreme positions since the conflict began. So, look, it's concerning because I think it will lead to the government being even more weak on this issue than it is already.
James, the government is just absolutely terrified that they're going to lose votes to the Greens. And so this is why you never get a really solid Labor senior frontbencher who says, no, I'm not going to stand for this. These protests have got to be stopped. And this stuff about river to the sea has got to end. You don't hear it because they're worried about losing votes to the Greens.
Yeah, no, look, I mean, only a very precious few ministers in this government have been strong on this. I'd say Bill Shorten has been pretty strong on this, to his credit. But, you know, I think there's another aspect of this that we need to explore here, because it's not just the Greens. The threat here is also that independent candidates stand, just like Di Lee stood in Fowler and, you know, scooped up that constituency when that was supposed to have been Christina Keneally's after the last election. Now, what's fascinating to me is that this is a funny sort of end result of multiculturalism, which, of course, Labor has been pushing for decades now. And now suddenly, you know, after decades of telling people, well, come to Australia, but, you know, still stay in touch with the home issues, vote the home issues back there, wherever you came from, you know, now they're really getting bitten by it. And I think that there's a real piece here, a larger piece around civics and unity as a nation and how we, you know, make migrants into Australians, that also needs to be explored, because I think that this incident puts this, you know, into real relief. But also, you know, this is not going to be the last time. Right now we have the Albanese government looking to court Lee Kang, the premier, and, you know, court Chinese Australian votes because of the relationships with China. This is interesting stuff, and we need to be, you know, I think, really focusing on Australian interests in all of this sort of thing.